What is art? Is it painting, music, literature, film, photography, and sculpture? No, those things are stupid. Art is the mighty Horsehead Nebula collapsing upon itself as the hydrogen gas ionizes in the heat of the nearby Sigma Orionis. Art is the great baby coyote cub taking its first steps in the arid African savanna. Art is the ache in the elderly man's swollen prostate as he yearns for the sweet release of urination. Art.
Who made you want to create art? Let me say this first of all, you don't create art, you make love to art. None of the so-called great artists that you've ever heard of have ever produced a satisfactory orgasm in Lady Art. Da Vinci could not maintain an erection. Pollock, premature ejaculator, never even achieved penetration. Duchamp could not find the clitoris, but there was one man who could produce those thunderous howls of ecstasy in Lady Art's vagina, and his name was Giovanni Baldovino. He only produced one work in his lifetime, unveiled March 31st, 1943. He stripped naked and threw himself off a cliff to his death. Of course, the mainstream art media ignored it, as they always do. But on that day, the only meaningful piece of art in the 20th century was created and then destroyed. But talking about art, as the great Camille de la Crescendo once said, is like trying to lick the sweet morning dew from the breast of a mermaid in the depths of the Mediterranean. You just can't do it. So let me show you some of my pieces. Bag Over Dolphin Neck, Eratification of Desire, by Ben Varian. Artist statement. The shopping bag over the lamp obviously represents the post-World War II consumerist mindset, which has been ripped to shreds by the artist. The dolphin lamp, of course, represents nature and purity. Its unadulterated luminosity reveals the transparent and hollow nature of the subject. Piece of Hair, Growth, Decay, and the Void, by Ben Varian, using materials provided by James Cito. A subtle critique of post-fascism in Italy, this piece is one of the most daring and controversial in art history. Themes of isolation and decay color the piece with a dark melancholy. The hair is quite obviously symbolic of the Paris peace treaties of 1947, while the white tape represents women's suffrage. This is a piece by one of my proteges, Kevin Mahoney. You can really see my influence in the use of gravity, specifically the dangling. Water Jugs on Fishing Line, The Futility of Man, by Kevin Mahoney. Can water truly be contained? Can the massive life force that created the Grand Canyon be tamed and domesticated for man's selfish purposes? These questions, along with the themes of equality and justice, are explored in Mahoney's latest work, one of his most poignant and challenging in decades. Review by Ben Varian, contemporary artist. Nice Leaf, by Ben Varian. Artist statement. This is just a nice leaf. Childish Artist Statement, Illusion of Simplicity, by Ben Varian. Artist statement. In this piece, I toy with the viewer's expectations like a cruel cat playing with a squirrel before devouring it. The childish naivety of this artist statement is a striking divergence from the masterful prose of my other work, leaving the viewer feeling alienated and betrayed. This is one of my most disturbing pieces. Thank you. I'm wearing a wig. Does this disturb you?
What is art?